Hi everyone, this is Aki with another Google Sheet video. We're going to go over how to calculate percentages in Google Sheets. And first we're just going to go over, you know, what is percentage. So percentage is a number of ratio as a fraction of 100. So you calculate, usually you have a number and what it is, you know, as a percentage as part of 100. So many times it's a referencing a fraction. When you have something like 45 over 100, it's expressed as a percentage, 45%. And you have this percent sign, which is basically a slash with two zeros on side of each. And we're going to also calculate, you know, how to calculate changes. So we're going to use data that's on states, state population change from 2010 to 2022. And then we're also going to use examples on how to calculate tip and sales tax rates, which are the frequent things that you have to deal with in your daily life. So let's get started. First thing we're going to learn how to calculate is a percentage of a portion. So I have this data here on states, on the United States, and we have data on population from 2010 and 2020. And we want to find out how many percentage of the new population of 2022 are new residents or newly born residents, because you could be residents moving in or also being born. So we're going to first calculate what's the how many people actually increased, the number of people increased from 2010 to 2022. So we take the number of 2022, subtract the 2010. That's the number. So now we have, you know, the number of change of how many people have increased in that state from 2010 to 2022. But sometimes that number doesn't really tell the whole story, because a big number, you know, in a very large state might be actually smaller as a percentage as a smaller number in a smaller state. So percentages are used to kind of like gauge and compare items in more clear ways. So the way to do that, in our case, we would take that number, the change, and divide by the new population. So we would do equal, take this number, divide by the 2022 population, and enter. Now, and here I will just copy it over, and you can see right away how this number for Alabama of 293,000 residents, it's almost 6%, while the California of 2.7 million of residents, also, I mean, almost 7. So you can see comparatively to the size of a state, this for Alabama and California are very close to each other. But if you just looked at the numbers themselves, it's not telling the whole story. So that's why percentages are useful. Now, right now here, I actually had this column formatted as percentages. However, you may not have that right away the first time you're doing calculation. Maybe you have, like, let's just do like a automatic number. So that's what you get. If you do the calculation and it's set up just by default as a number, you will see a fraction. So this is a fraction. And you'll be like, okay, what is this? I don't want, this is not helpful. So what you have to do is select either the column, let's say I'm going to select, and you can select format as percent at the top of your menu or ribbon. And here it will format this as a percentage. Now you can see you have decimal points, decimal places. You can specify how many decimal places you want. Maybe you want just a whole number, or you want to see the decimal places. And so this is the way to format it. You can also do format, number, and then select percentage or custom number format at the bottom. I'm just going to do it this way. Now, let's say there's also one more thing that you can do. There's actually a formula. It's the name of the formula in Google Sheets. It's 2%. And you can take the number and it converts it to percentage this way. So if you have it formatted, you know, as a decimal, you can use the formula. But most people just do a manual format change through the menu. The second way you can use percentages is calculating an item as a percent of total. So in our case, you know, we have a population for 2022 for the whole United States by state. So if we want to, if you're curious how much this 5 million for Alabama is as a percentage of US. So just by this number, it's hard to you, it's hard for you to tell. So what you have to first do, you have to add up all the numbers. So we're just going to use sum formula. And did it select? Let me just see, make sure that it selects from A3 to A52. It did, and click enter. So the total population for United States for the 2022, with the 2022 data, it's about 335 million. So this is the total. So now if I want a percentage for each of the state, how much their population is of the whole United States, I would have to calculate, take this number for each of the state and divide it by the whole population of United States. So I'm just going to do equal population of 2022 divided by this total. And now if I do that, and if I try to copy the formula, it's going to be messed up. Why? Because I have to make sure that the total, it's always going to be an absolute reference. So I actually have to select this and make this an absolute reference, because it will not change. When I copied over the formula, it was referring to cells going down farther, so it was a relative reference. So you want to be aware that your total most of the time has to be an absolute reference. And now if I copy over all of this, now I have the information of for each state what's the percentage of their population as a whole from the United States. So California is the largest, so 11.9% is the total of the whole United States live in California. So percentage wise, you can see it's largest. And then we just have few, there are like six for Florida. So 6%, 6.6% of population of United States live in Florida. And then, you know, you have few other states like Texas, about 9% live in Texas of the whole. So this is much more helpful. And you can see some of these states are very tiny, like Alaska, 0.2%. So this is really helpful, like having a percentage, then you can really have an idea. And then you can sort this. If we wanted to sort this, we can just sort this by percentages to have a clearer idea, or maybe use conditional formatting to highlight the top 10. Now, the third way you want to use percentages many times to find out change from one time to another time. So let's say we have this data for census 2010 for each of the states, and then 2022, and we want to know how much the state grew. So here we were just calculating new residents as of 2022, but now we want to find out, let me hide these two columns, how much it grew, the state grew from 2010 to 2022. So we are going to use some of the data we calculated before, but the calculation for growth is different. It's you take the new value, subtract the old value, and divide by old value. So I'm actually going to put the formula text here for you. I like to do that just so you can see the formula when it's being changed. Right now it's an A because I have no formula, but right now we're going to change the formula so you will see it. So we take the population 2022, subtract the old population of 2010, and divide it by 2010. Why are we dividing by 2010? Because that's our base value where we want to compare to. It used to be 4,779,000. Now it's 5 million. So you want to use the 4,779,000 as the base amount. That's why you're dividing by the old value, and you're subtracting the difference, and you're using the difference between these two as how much it has changed. And you press enter, and you have 6.14%. That means that state grew by 6.14%. And then you can just, you know, calculate for all of the states. Now, did I use absolute references? I didn't. I could have used for the columns, because the columns have not changed. However, the rows will be changing by the formula when it's going down. And so I'm not using absolute reference. So this is basically growth since 2010. So actually, let me take this and copy it here. So that's the one. Let me just copy over the colors right there. Okay, so that's how you calculate growth or change. Now you could have that growth going negative as well, and I can show you there's a couple of states that have negative value, like let's say Illinois. Illinois is one that actually has a change that's negative. You can see that the number of people in that state has actually decreased slightly. So if we open our formulas here, I can see how many millions have moved from the state, about 21,000. So not that many, but it's still a negative growth. So that's how you calculate percent change between two values in Google Sheets. Now, another way to calculate percentages is, or use percentage in Google Sheet, is if you have a percentage and you want to calculate a number using the percentage. So you have, you know that the population in 2010, let's say was, let me hide this column, was 4,779,000, and you know that it has increased since 2010 by 6.14%, and you want to calculate how that means how many people have moved or were born as an increase for the state. So we have the percentage, but we want to calculate the number. So the way to do it is you take the whole number and you multiply by the percentage change. And this is the amount that we have. And you can see what? That this is actually what we calculated before when we took the difference between population of 2022 and 2010. So this number, that difference, is also a way you can calculate it if you just have a percent of increase of population from 2010 to 2022. If you have that number and just the population of 2010, you can calculate how many people have moved or were born additionally between those 12 years. So that's the another way to use percentages to do a calculation. You could also use this percentage to figure out what's the population right now in 2022 if you just basically take the 2010 information and add this number, right? The number that we calculated, the actual number. And I'll show you with the tip example and tax example how you can do that. Now let's just calculate some of the useful ways that you can use percentages to calculate tip and sales tax, which are frequently done situations in real life that you can come across. And I'll show you with this example where we have food costs. We went to a restaurant, it's about $100, let's say we paid, and we have option of adding a 5, 10%, 15, or 20% tip. And how would we know what would be the total that we have to pay? So the quick way is basically, if you have this, these numbers here, I formatted as percentages, so they're not taxed. And then here, what I would do is take equal and then take that number. Now I want to make sure I use the absolute value for this number because I'm going to be copying it across. And then I'm going to multiply by the percentage. So the percentage doesn't have to be absolute because I'm going to copy it and it has to change from 5% to 20, and I can copy it over. So now I know that 5% of 100 is $5, 20% of 100 is $20, and so on. Now this is not the total. Now I still have to add, because this is just a tip, so it means I have to take the 100 plus the 5 to find out the total. So I would do is take the 100 absolute value, because this is going to be referencing that cell across, plus the amount that we calculated. And here, you see, now I know that if I add 5% tip, I have to, the total will be 105. If I select 20% tip, I have to pay $120. Now there's an alternative way to calculate this quickly in just one calculation. So what you can do, you can take the number that you have originally, absolute value, and then you want to plus add, and here we can just perform the calculation directly in one formula, basically taking this number again and multiplying by 5% and entering. And here right away it tells me that the total is 105, 120 based on the tip amount. So I just could perform one calculation by taking it this way. Or you can also do another way, which is basically taking this total, absolute value, times, and now percentage is basically, in this situation, we take 100, so 100%, so that's 1, plus 5%. So it will be 1 plus, and here I would say select this percentage right there. And here I would have the calculation done quickly as well. And I'm going to just copy over this so you can see the formula, how it's calculated. So these are the different ways that you can, you know, calculate tip amount or percentages that you can use to figure out how much you have to pay, or, you know, how much the amount would be if you know the percentage. Now, another example here is like with sales tax, for example. You have, you know, this is the amount of cost of your shopping, and you have different sales tax rate that I pulled from Tax Foundation, and you want to find out how much would be the sales tax if you purchase this item in some store. So what you want to do is take the amount, you use absolute value, and then you multiply by the rate, and then you can copy this across, and it tells you how much that would be. And then if you want to, how much would be the sales tax, but that has to be added on top of your cost of your item, so you have to add these two together. And I want to make sure I have absolute value for my $100, because that won't change, and this will also show you that way. And you can also do it like we showed here, the alternative calculation, which is just basically directly taking the $100, multiplying times 1 plus sales tax amount. And again, I forget to add the absolute value for this amount. And then you have the calculation done right away. So you don't have the two-step process right here. Once you feel comfortable, you're able to do this very quickly with just one formula. Thanks so much for watching.